Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In the last video, we've learned how to import heavy 3D objects to RoboDK. We also learned a method on how to simplify these heavy 3D objects so that we can have fluid simulation. In this video, we will learn other methods to do so and the drawbacks that are related. Let's get started. So here we still have our laser tracker, so our heavy 3D model. You can open that station or the station here, heavy step file, perfect. There's a few other methods to simplify a 3D model. Some are good or some are useful in certain situations. Some are less useful in certain situations. So we'll try to kind of look at those. So if you go to tools and then options under display, you will find here under display performance, certain settings. So by default, here you have simplify object and remove small objects. So if I go for simplify object, select this one here, and I select my tracker here, or if I select the station, if I select the station, all the objects in the station will be affected. But if I select just my tracker like that, and I click OK, it will say, okay, you had 15,280 polygons, and now it was scaled down to 2. So that's kind of the exact same effect as opening the color or color selector or change color tool, right-clicking, and then merge mesh or group mesh, in fact. So this has pretty much the same effect plus other effect in the background. So if I do so, here I have a very fluid station where I'm running at about 63 FPS, which is as fluid as I really want it to be. I can close that here, click no, reopen the same file here. Perfect. And I can go to tools and options. By the way, Shift O will bring you to tools options. I can go to display. Another thing I can do is remove small objects. So if I do so, it will ask me to remove all objects that are smaller than a certain size. I can click OK and select my tracker. Here in this case, it removed 5,700 polygons over the 15 ones that were available. And it also removed 221,000 small triangles. But I know here for a fact, I already tried it in the past, that this method in this case here doesn't work properly or do not give you the effect you would hope for. So as you can see here, it kind of removed a lot of small polygons that were all over the place. So now our part is kind of see-through, which is not what we want. By the way, this is another one-way feature. So you can't go back from this feature apart from just re-importing the 3D model. But this here will have great effect if you have a generally, let's say a normal part, but it has like a lot of bolts in it or bolts, threads, or other small elements like that. You can run that remove small object feature and it will indeed remove all those smaller screws and lighter down your 3D model. So here I will simply close that and reopen it again. By the way, Control 1 to reopen the latest object. So here, if I go for tool options again and display, another thing you can do, first of all, if you have a GPU or graphic card on your computer, I would recommend you to select use GPU arrays, especially for bigger files, it will have a huge impact. Then if you're really stuck and things are very heavy, and you can't really reduce the amount of polygons, I'm going to show you why grouping the mesh is not always the best idea. I'm going to show you a good example of that in a few minutes. But if you want, you can use the don't display object smaller than and a certain percentage of the screen. So that what will that do is, like, if an object is in the foreground like this one here, everything will be visible because all the 3D models represents at least 0.05% of the screen, something like that. But if I start zooming out Here you don't see the difference, but I can see it potentially very small. That's where it's very interesting. Some smaller objects won't be rendered when they are farther away. It doesn't matter because you don't see them. So to kind of increase the way you can see it, I'm going to bring that, let's say, to 2%. Click OK. I wouldn't necessarily recommend you to go any further than like 1, 1.5, something like that. But here you can see that some objects are really starting to disappear as I'm zooming in and out. Like I said, this was very just for the example here so that you can see the behavior. But as I'm zooming out, the object will disappear because it takes less than 2% of the screen. Or in fact, the surfaces takes less than 2% of the screen. So here, 1, 1.5 if you need it, is the best you can do. But in my case, I don't need to use this one here as my computer is powerful enough. And that with just simplifying the object, it works. Okay, so like I said, simplifying the object is great. It will give you a lot more frames per second in your 3D environment, but it has some drawbacks. And the main drawback is every features that relies on that 3D objects to work. So let's say the teach target on surface that we used before, or the measurement tool, won't be as effective or even be completely broken if you try to apply them onto a simplified object. So for example here, I'm gonna create a frame here, reset the frame to the origin of the station, bring that here, so just so that you can better see the frame. So as you can see here, we have our frame one, and which is the origin of our 3D model, and the 3D model is here. So as I showed you in the past, what you can do is tools and then measure. In the next video, we'll talk more about the measuring tool. You can select, I don't know, this curve here. It will give you the center point here. You can press copy. You can move out of here, double click this one here, select more option, and then paste, and then here invert pause. And then now it's right where it should be. So that's great. Let's say that I'm trying to do the same thing, but I'm going to create a new frame. I'm going to bring in, wrong button. I'm going to bring in the same SLD file I opened before or created before, so I won't take too long. Here, let's give it this one a name. So just tracker so that I can differentiate the two of these. Okay, so now if I go tools, options, display, and then simplify object, if I simplify this one here, click OK, it will bring the triangle or surfaces count down from 15,000 to 2. Click OK, OK. And then if I go tool and then measure, and if I try to bring it here, you will see it's super laggy and I'm kind of not able to get a grasp on. It was so easy with the other one. You remember, I was just kind of bringing my mouse near of that curve here and it was giving me the point right in the middle. But here it's very laggy. It's possible, it will work, but it will take like way longer. So this, everything related to the simplify, and here you can see it even crashed my instance of RoboDK. So I would highly recommend, if you need to measure, if you need to use the teach target on surface, if you need to extract curves, I'm going to show you later in another module how you can extract curve to follow them with the robot and all. If you need to do that, do it on a fresh file or a file that was not simplified. But if we're talking about a conveyor, some fencing, if we talk about the pedestal of the robot, everything that you don't need to interact per se, do it, go for it, just simplify everything. Your whole general experience with RoboDK will be way better. So again, if I just bring back this one here in comparison, tool, measure, and I'm just here, and bam, I can have my measure here. It will be the same, like I said, for the teach target on surface. The teach target on surface will be a bit wicked if you're trying to use it on a simplified object. One thing that you should do absolutely though, remember when we had surfaces on top of surfaces that were hiding the colors underneath? That's kind of also giving twice as much work to RoboDK because it has to render that false layer of color plus the layer of colors. So if you can delete that mesh, this won't impact your the way that the feature target on surface or measure or extract curve works, because you just removed extra information, but you didn't remove the information that we actually need to extract those features. So so that's it. Okay, one last quick thing before we finish on this subject. You have another file here, or another RoboDK file called Heavy Tool. If I'm bringing this one here, it's a Fennec robot with a simple tool. And in this case here, it's not that heavy. I didn't find like the exactly right example. But if you bring in a 3D model and every time you kind of, I'm gonna press plus a few times here, every time you go on top of some edges or near edges, you can see all of those little lines with arrows appearing and everything. And it was not on purpose, because later down this training, I'm gonna show you how you can extract those and use them as robot path. That's super handy. That's a very cool feature. But in this case here, it's not very useful. Here we don't have that many showing, and so it won't impact our performance that much. But let's say, imagine if you have a heat sink or something like that. It will create a line like that every time you have an edge. So you would have lines like this everywhere. Worse than that, if you go tools and options, and for some reason under a display you have display curve like that here, you will see all the curves that were exported here, and now your performance will be very bad. So here in this case, I have a hard time reaching more than 9 FPS, which is a bit laggy, like very the bottom limit of what is usable. So this happens for two main reasons. It can be an exportation settings if you use IGES. If you use IGES and you look at your exportation settings in your CAD software, so your 3D modeling software, you might see something relating to exporting curves, exporting edges, something like that. And when it's important in RoboDK, those edges are extracted and are showing. So that might be the issue. The other potential issue is like under tools, options, CAD, if you have generate edges for each surface, that can be useful in certain cases, but in most cases, it's not. So that will, like I said, just generate an edge for each, in fact, a curve for each edges that you can see. And here you have import all curves and points, import all curve normals accurately. And that can also create those lines. So anyway, that's not a big deal. If you have those and you don't know how to set up RoboDK in a way that it does not create those automatically, you just have to right-click the 3D model you have here and you can select delete curves. In fact, I selected one curve. I need to delete all curves. So if you just click on one curve, it will give you the option to delete that curve. If you right-click on a place where there is no curves, you will have the option to delete all curves. If you do that, it will simply remove all the curves. And as you see, I went from 9 FPS to 63 FPS. So I kind of gained back all what I needed. Okay, that's pretty much everything on how to deal with heavy 3D objects. If you think I forgot anything, you can leave a comment. If you want, you can, by the way, it would be cool to have a discussion on those topics. So potentially you could go to our forum and start a topic in the, we have a community section. So under the community section, I might start a topic on the general subjects of these trainings so that we can have a grouped conversation. If you have questions, if you have comments, stuff that I should add. So feel free to go there. I will definitely add something in the near future here. So roboDK.com/forum. under community, I might start a new thread here so that we can discuss what we have, so we can discuss what we are covering here in this training. In the next video, we will learn how to split and regroup objects. So that can be very useful if you have heavy 3D models like we just saw, potentially being able to kind of split them and treat them in separated batches so that you can have your jig on one side and the part on the other side, so that you can simplify the jig because you don't have to interact with the jig, but you can keep the part completed or complete so that you can really extract the features or do teach target on surface. That will be very useful to learn. Hope to see you there. Have a great day, guys.